A very good morning, dear children. How are you all? Welcome to the video tutorial of computer class, where we will be continuing with chapter number 6, editing a worksheet. So let's start. In today's tutorial, we will be understanding the concept of undo and redo first of all. Undo button and redo button both are present in quick access toolbar. Undo button is used to cancel the changes that you have made in your spreadsheet. By using this command, you can undo your last 16 actions. Clear? Now coming upon to the redo command, redo command is used to quickly repeat the last action that you have cancelled using the undo command. Means the action that you have cancelled by using the undo command, that can be quickly repeated by using redo button. These two buttons, as I have already told, they are present on the quick access toolbar. Clear? Now, the next concept that we are going to study in Excel is your autofill feature. MS Excel 2013, it provides you a new feature, and that feature is named as autofill feature, which allows you to copy the cell contents. Means by using this feature of Excel 2013, you can fill the data in the cells automatically. You do not need to type the data. The data in the cells can be filled automatically with the help of the autofill feature. Clear beta? So now let's learn how you can use the autofill feature. Here what I will do, I will create a spreadsheet of your test schedule by using the autofill feature. Here I will be typing the serial number. Here the days will be typed. Clear? Now one thing you have to keep in mind, in case of numbers beta, when you want to use the autofill feature, at that time you need to type two consecutive numbers, like 1 then 2. Now two consecutive numbers I have typed. Now I will select those two consecutive numbers. Now what you will have to do, you will bring your mouse pointer to the right corner of the cell. You can see this plus sign. You have to drag this plus handle, that is called as your autofill handle. Now you can see the series, it has been automatically filled. Clear? In the same way, where I want to type the days, I will type the first day of the week, that is Monday. Again, bring your mouse pointer to the right corner. Then you can drag it to fill the contents in the cell. Clear beta ji? So this is the way you can use the autofill feature. You didn't need to type all the data over here. Just you need to use the autofill feature. Here you can type your subjects accordingly, like maths. Then you can type English, whatever test days you want. You can use any of the subjects according to your own choice. Clear beta? So this is the way you can make the use of the autofill feature. Clear beta? I hope this concept is clear to you all. Now let us revise quickly the shortcut keys which will help you to perform different actions on your spreadsheet. The first one is to select the active row. In order to select the active row, the shortcut key used is Shift plus space bar. Now, in order to select the active column, what do you mean by active column? Active column means the column that is currently active or the column that you are currently working in. So, in order to select the active column, the shortcut key is Ctrl plus spacebar key. Now, in order to select the entire worksheet, means when you want to select the complete worksheet, the shortcut key will be used control plus A. In order to copy the data of your Excel spreadsheet, the shortcut key is control plus C. In order to paste the copied data, or in order to paste the data from new to the new location, the shortcut key is control plus V. Then in order to cut the data, means in order to move the data from one place to another, the shortcut key used is control plus X. So these are some of the shortcut keys which will help you to quickly perform your actions on the Excel spreadsheet. I hope today's concept is clear to you all. Take care of yourself. Have a wonderful day ahead.